Sonny Edwards is your fighter with a cut like that. Just stop it. Why make him go through that? What happened, Robert? What happened?
I'm saying, better not y'all can be steroids. Charles, you know your shit, right?
Why not?
The
steroids, I don't know shit. I don't know how to do the injection, but.
No, but he's an Olympian. He doesn't fail drug tests. He's fighting Travis's brother, right?
Always
Omar.
Clean. Always clean.
Always clean. Chihuahua. Chihuahua, Mexico.
No, I won't do it. This fucker came here with like United Airlines. What? Not even alcohol.
What is that?
Those are clean. That is what the one.
Yeah,
those are
clean.
Those are alcohol. Those have alcohol.
What is it, Robert?
It's a white piece that United Airlines gives you. You know, that little.
What's wrong with that?
Exactly. Yeah, you can use that one. I mean, you can use that one.
You have hand sanitizer if you need.
Yeah, hand sanitizer.
Alright, we're gonna do this. Hold on. Alright, you absolve me of all liability, yes? I have no liability. If you give me a flexion, anything goes wrong, it's not my fault.
Yeah, no problem.
That's right, Charles.
You know, celebrities do that to girls they date. Like, you won't come after me if we okay. Yeah.
Okay, I want to have a girl sign of liability.
You know, you're gonna fucking suck my dick, right? You know you're gonna. I'm gonna fuck you hard. Yeah. So you can't fucking go to.
Yeah.
I'm
signing. That's what they do, no, for insurance. Because like otherwise they'll go after them for nonsense like that.
Is it? Crazy,
yeah, but that's the world we live in.
Myself,
people want paydays, and that's an easy payday. So how come, Robert, one fighter fails a drug test and gets 6 months, one fighter fails the same drug test and gets a year? How come boxing does...
Another fighter fails the drug test and still fights that same weekend.
Yes. Why is that? How come there's no consistency? Who makes the rules?
The commission where you're at, the sanctioning body also has a lot to do with it. It's fucking weird, man.
But it's not right. Everybody should... the same rules for everybody.
It is weird, you know... It is good, but there's states that are a lot more harder than others. There's a few states that don't give a fuck. You know, one fighter tests positive, and they still let them fight, and they're drug testing everybody in the fucking locker room.
But he just failed the test.
Exactly, but the main event just failed the test, and they're still testing the undercard. You know what I mean? And then there's fighters that get fined millions of dollars, and then there's those that they just get a slap in the wrist, you know.
Do you think that you remember Haney pushed Loma, and they said it was a $400,000 fine, but then they put it down to nothing, to like $10,000, $20,000, $40,000. Why announce $400,000 when it's not even?
I don't remember that.
It was at Dwayne. It was a hard push. Loma
pushed him, but I don't remember.
They said $400,000.
Because Loma could have easily said, I got injured.
He could have, yeah.
And he would still got paid and everything. But he's, you know, Loma's badass, man. And yeah. I thought Loma won that fight.
I thought so, too. But is there a problem in boxing with steroids or substance abuse with any kind?
I think it's all over, not just boxing. I think it's everywhere. I think it's every sport. I think everybody wants to take that advantage. Every fighter, every team, every wants to take that advantage. There's very few teams that will not allow it, you know. But I also know that there's a lot of fighters, and I do believe, you know, that it could have happened to Ryan also. Every fighter trusts every conditioning coach they hire, their trainer for sure. They trust the tia, the mom, the grandma. I'm telling you. Just recently, my dad gave Pita some Mexican
medication.
Medication pills, for the stomach. It's, everybody was getting sick here in the gym.
I remember 2 weeks ago.
And my dad told him, here, Peter, take this one. And Peter's like, fuck, that shit fucking stopped it. But then Peter Googled it, and it does have something that's illegal. So, can it happen to any fighter? Of course. Can I say Ryan knew exactly what he was taking? No, because a lot of fighters believe in their conditioning coach, and their nutritionist, and their dad, and their mom, and their tia, grandma, grandpa.
Oh, they
believe in it, bro. I'm telling you, I've proved it to a lot of people by telling them, you know, that I can do it, and they won't find out with the hand wraps too. You know, they didn't say it on TV, but. That's why I'm telling you that boxing, you have to be careful with everything. When we were in the locker room with Bam, the inspectors, you know, the commissioners, they did not, you know, they didn't say who, but they told me, Estrada's team wants to come see you wrap hands. I said, okay, that's fine. It's a championship fight. They have all the right to. Yeah. But if they're gonna do it, I'm gonna do
correct.
It too.
Yes.
So I sent Pita. Okay, so that's fine. His their guy was there with me, and I went through my hands and everything. Everything was good. He's, you know, he okayed everything. And then I told him, okay. But now, when we glove up, I want to do the same thing. I want to send somebody to see you guys glove up, and you guys could send somebody.
Why do you want to see someone glove up, Robert?
Because a lot of fighters, I'm not saying they did, because yes. I'm going to tell you, that's not true.
Yeah.
But a lot of they could wet their hand, they could wet their gloves. I've seen it happen
and
before.
The commission won't notice.
And they won't even notice. Fighters go to the bathroom, and they could fucking wash their hands, and they're.
Or they could tell the commission a butterfly, and he'll turn around.
And they'll wet the gloves, might get hard. I don't know. Something, I don't know.
So
they maybe put something that's gonna harden the. You never know.
The tape, yeah.
Bad, you know, you're in the. You're, the inspector's in the locker room. He's not fucking. He doesn't have the eyes 100%. Sometimes you distract him so easy.
Yeah, no, I need a new pair of gloves. Give me my backup.
Some shit, you know.
I've seen it. Yeah.
So I said, I want, you know, when you glove up, I want to do something. And the guy says, okay, that's fine.
He agreed.
So he went. Then by the time we were gonna glove up, I told him, go tell him that I'm gonna glove up. But we want to make sure we see the same thing. And Pita goes out there, and Pita's like, he's already gloved up. So Pita started, you know, you guys have to do it again. They didn't want to do it. They started arguing. So I went over there, and I said, look, I don't have a problem. But since you guys asked to check my glove, my wraps, I said I want to see the gloves too. I want to see the gloves.
The championship fight, you have every right.
And I said, I told the guy that was there, the guy that in their team, I said, did I tell you or didn't I tell you that I wanted to? He's like, yeah, you did tell me. And then the trainer, Caballero, actually, he's like, okay, if you said yes, then we're going to do it. So they took it off, and then
you checked that it was dry?
I checked the guy. It was
okay,
it was
then good. That's good.
And then I let him glove up again. Nothing wrong, but I did tell him, you have to do it again.
And they did it.
Because you know, we did it with the gloves, not want to do it with the glove.
Okay, so what does the commission say throughout this?
Nah, they're okay with it. They're okay with it. So, because you never know. So a lot of, you know, could get it wet, could put some, you know, the trainer might have something in his hand, you know.
You're right, we never know.
Never know.
You don't want to live with that. We should have, could have.
Yeah,
been.
Never know. So that happened, you know. Then it wasn't a big deal. They didn't make a big deal. The trainer said.
I saw you handshake afterwards.
No. Very professional, man. Very professional. So the trainer said, if you agree to it, then we have to do it because his teammate said yes to it. You know what I mean? So you just have to know that things could happen. And I'm gonna say it again. And okay, back to the commission.
Yeah.
Arizona. I want to bring it up too whenever I fight in Arizona again. Whenever I fight in Arizona again, I want to bring it up to when they do the rules meeting. Because they have rules, okay? They have a lot of rules.
I'm saying, what do you think about that?
My fighters, as soon as they walk into the locker room, so far my inspectors are probably the most strict guys. They follow the fucking rules.
I've seen it.
As soon as my fighter gets into the locker room, they tell him you have to wash your hair off because you have gel in your hair, okay? Last time we were there in March with Raymond and Lindolfo, same thing. You guys have to wash it off. Okay.
But in the same locker room, we had another fighter that had gel in his
from
ear.
Another and then, yeah. Huh? From another team.
Yeah. From another team. Yeah. And they didn't tell him nothing. Okay? So if they're gonna enforce the rules, enforce them with everybody.
Be consistent.
Yep. With everybody. And whoever runs the Arizona Commission, when they do their meetings, they have to tell them, fucking do the same thing with everybody. Because check this out. In March, about the gel, okay? So I even argued, hey, this guy's right here fucking next to us, and you didn't tell him nothing?
What are you telling him?
And when he walked into the fight, you're telling my, as soon as he walked into the fight, you're telling my fighter, go wash your hair because you have gel in your. I said, but this guy had fucking gel.
He was walking into the ring.
Because he was already walking. So he waited until my fighter
came back.
Until that other guy left to tell my fighter, okay, Lindolfo washed his hair up. So what? Who gives a fuck? Then they also have a strict rule of Vaseline. Arizona only allows Vaseline in this part of the face.
Did you see Guy Estrada's?
Oh, wait up! That's why! Okay. Only in this part right here, okay?
That's it.
That's all they allow. So, I go back to March.
Every day?
That same fighter that walked out with Jao and everything, you know, very popular kid. I'm not, you know, I love the kid. You know, we're fucking family. But his team, in front of the commissioners, in front of the inspectors, were doing the Vaseline all over his body. And I'm not hating on the kid because I don't give a fuck.
Do what you gotta
do. I'm not fighting against him.
30 seconds.
But he walks out to the arena with Vaseline covered all over his body. And to us, it's only right here. Nowhere else in the fucking body. Only right here.
Wow.
Okay? Okay, so this weekend, my inspector, strict kid, which I don't mind. So all we were allowed was right here. And I did that. The first few rounds, I had no problem. But then, like, towards the last, like the sixth or seventh round, when I seen Gallo, when the bell rings, I seen Gallo's face. God damn, he got Vaseline all over the fucking
floor. 3 inches deep.
Exactly.
I saw that.
And I told, and that's why everybody was asking me, why were you arguing with the inspector? Because I told the inspector, hey, look at that shit. If you guys are allowing that shit, I'm doing the same shit.
What do you say?
You can't do it. You can't do it. I'm like, yes, I am. So next round, I just a little bit right here.
Yeah.
And he's like, you can't do it. I'm like, why not? If that fucker's doing it, how come they're not telling him? Well, we're going to go tell him. Yeah, but it's too late. He already has it.
Yep.
So I watched the fight, and I'm not fucking riding the inspector out, but motherfuckers, they got to pay attention to, if everybody's going to be strict, then.
Here's the Robert. His inspector is to do a job. And if he's bad at his job, okay, he needs to get called on it.
Exactly.
So I would fire him.
So yeah, so they should get called. And I'm sorry, whoever the inspector was.
But he has to learn the rules.
But look. The inspector's right there. In the first fucking round, Caballero grabs a lot of Vaseline and puts it all over his face. And the inspector didn't say shit. And that was in the first round. If you watch the fight, they show the corner and Caballero grabs Vaseline and puts it all over his face. When, to me, it was in on Bam's fight, but I think it was Cardenas' fight. I have Vaseline, so I do what I'm supposed to do. The rest, I just did this to Cardenas. Like, the rest,
Rub
and the inspector told me to fucking wipe it off.
Wow.
I did the nose and the eyes, and then the other, whatever I had left, I just did this to his face, to his chin, and the inspector, nope, wipe it off. Okay, but then fucking Caballero's right all over his face, and then that sixth or seventh round is when I see his, His fucking, like you said, 2 inches.
I saw that, like fucking, a facial.
Yeah.
It was everywhere. Round six, I think.
If they're going to do it, if they're going to have that rule, fucking
apply
have it
to everybody.
Apply it to everybody.
Don't give 1% advantage.
Yes.
How does Vaseline help, though, Robert?
Huh?
How does it help? To slide the punches, or?
Man, that's sometimes where, and then, you know, a lot of times, you know, the fighter gets it in the gloves. So, you know, a body shot, you know, it does help. If, or else nobody would use it.
Is it the same inspector every fight or different?
No, they have different inspectors.
But the same mentality, yeah.
But they all have the same rules. They all have the same. They have the same main guy that tells them what the rules
but
are.
But why would Arizona say only the eyes? Where everywhere else, I travel all over the world. No one has a limit like that. Not in Europe. Not in Asia.
California doesn't allow it in your body either.
Yeah.
But you can put it
in
the face. In the right here.
Yeah.
In the face. California allows it.
most of the other states allow
everything. Yeah.
Some in the body.
That's true.
But Arizona only allows it right here only. But fuck, that shit was like you said.
But what if that would have made a difference in a fight? You know what I mean?
They might. You never know. So if my inspector was fucking so strict and wouldn't allow me to do nothing, then their inspector.
He should have stopped the fight. Go and take wipe your face. Tell the ref to wipe his face.
Because I'm telling you, and I went back to see, you know, when I got home, I seen the fight all over again, and I wasn't looking for that, but I seen the first round. I'm like, what the fuck? This is the first round they're doing this. It wasn't just, you know, that seventh round or sixth round. It was since round one they were putting it all over his face. So that inspector should be told something. Hey,
you're not doing your job.
Better fucking, you know, do your job.
What did you see different in the replay that you didn't notice on Fight Night besides that?
I'm going to go back to another story. I'm not going to say which state either. My dad is wrapping hands. Okay, my dad is wrapping somebody's hands. And the inspector tells me, hey, Robert, your dad can't use that much tape. You know, because maybe he was using a little bit too much tape. And I'm like, why? He's like, yeah, because that's the rule. You're going to use one roll per hand. So my dad used a little bit more, you know, than one roll. And I'm like, okay, so tell him. He's like, I can't tell your dad that. I'm like, then fucking that's your job. Why are you telling me? So you can tell your dad. I'm like, no, you do your job and you tell him. He's like, nah, I can't tell your dad that. Then
don't say nothing.
And my dad, nobody told my dad, so my dad did what he's used to doing.
Your dad's very good at wrapping hands, by the way.
He was really good. So they didn't tell him. They let him get away with it. So what? You know what I mean? You know, that's why there's so many states that don't allow tape under.
It's called stacking, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so how does it work? Tape?
Look, we put tape, maybe not on the skin. We put one layer.
Try those.
One layer of gauze, and then tape, and then gauze, the whole wrap. And then tape over.
You could do it in Vegas, right?
Vegas and Arizona.
Okay.
Arizona also allows it.
But not California.
California doesn't. So if Canelo fights in Vegas, he's allowed to do it. And I remember
Triple G scam
was all, you know, you're stacking. Well, Nevada does allow it. Arizona also allows it.
That's not cheating.
You know, the other thing that sometimes I'm not, you know, I really don't like, California and Arizona, you have to make the padding out of the gauze. Which there's some gauze paddings that we could get like at Walgreens, which is nothing illegal. It's gauze. It's just a little bit thicker, like this thick.
Yeah.
And you could, you know, the rolls are thicker, but they're really soft. They're actually not even gonna help you win a fight, but they're soft. But they're this wide, so it's perfect size for a wrist. So it's a lot easier to make the padding. It's just, you know, it's so much easier because you fold it up and it's actually softer, but California doesn't allow it and Arizona doesn't allow it, but it's a lot easier and it's actually softer, so it's not helping you win a fight. But with California and Arizona, you have to make it out of gauze, that 2-inch gauze.
The Mexican.
You have to make it, and then you put it and you have to fold it. So sometimes when you fold it, it's a little bit harder to fold because it's made, you know, you have to roll it, you know, down, up, then down, up, down to make it thick. So it's a little more difficult. That's one thing I think our commission should allow. It's things you buy at Walgreens, nothing illegal about it. It's just thicker and softer. It's actually softer for the hands. So it's not going to help you win a fight or hit harder.
A famous coach once told me that they used to use tampons.
They used to.
Right, you knew that? They used to use tampons? No, I'm serious.
Yeah, they did. I remember when I was fighting. My dad never used it, but I remember. They used to allow it.
You can wrap your hands in tampons.
Then they stopped doing it. Yeah, a lot of trainers used to take tampons to use the padding as panties. See?
Neta, to absorb the blood.
It is true.
But what do we use here?
Huh?
Vagisil.
What do we use?
Oh, Vagisil.
Vagisil.
But Chino takes out a lot.
He's working.
You know what? Antes, before, I remember there was fights in a hotel. Fighters would come from their hotel already wrapped up.
Wow.
Del cuarto, yeah. They already come wrapped up into the locker room. There was not too much inspection, not too much, you know. They would get.
So inspection's not a bad idea, but they have to be fair. You can't give one guy a clear advantage and be very strict on the other one.
You know, that in March in Arizona, when, you know, that kid right there has gel all over his head, all over his hair. And when he goes to fight, you tell him, my fighters, you got to wash your hair. You should have told that kid too. Or Vaseline. You only allow it in the fucking eyes?
Yeah.
Well, you should have told him something because he had Vaseline all over his body. There's videos of them putting Vaseline.
That was insane.
That's called business. Because obviously, guy on a rematch gets paid a lot, so they want to make sure the fight will be close. So that judge came. I think that just came from home.
That was good, but I think also the knockdown helped a lot. You know, it helped Gallo get the rematch.
One of the judges gave Estrada the round that he got knocked down in. He got knocked down, and they still gave him the round.
They still gave him the round?
It was a complete domination the entire round.
Yeah, one judge, the Mexican judge only gave Bam two rounds.
And they gave him the round that he got dropped in.
And I think Bam lost maybe the round that he got dropped. Well, he didn't even lose that round. But it was because of the knockdown. Maybe he lost. Yeah.